Welcome to Pastor's Chat. We're looking at Colossians chapter 1, the prayer of the Apostle Paul for the saints at Colossae, that I'm convinced that if we pray this prayer, if we have people praying this prayer for us, it will make an impact upon our lives, upon the lives of others, and we can advance the kingdom of God on earth. You know, the Lord's Prayer teaches us to pray, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done." Well, that's what this prayer really is. It follows the model prayer that Jesus gives us there in Matthew 6, and it is a model prayer for us to pray in this New Testament era in which we live. And so I'm trusting that God's using this to help you develop a prayer life that will make the difference in the lives of others. I need the practice in prayer. You need the prayers of others. I need people praying for me. It's a circle that begins with the Holy Spirit inspiring us, initiating prayer within us to call on the name of our God. And so Paul said he prayed without ceasing. Are you praying without ceasing? Are you asking God without ceasing that God would help and strengthen and encourage and lift up others as he prayed, that they would know the will of God in all spiritual wisdom and understanding? Now, as we get toward the end of this brief, small prayer that is so powerful, he says, "May you be strengthened with all power according to his glorious might for all endurance and patience with joy." All endurance with patience and joy. Oh, my friend, when you know the Holy Spirit of God is energizing you, you'll have patience to deal with the situations and problems that we face. The Bible says, "Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience, but let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, lacking nothing." James chapter 1. And so we have patience and endurance. We're able to continue doing what God wants us to do. And then there's an inner joy when people are praying for us, when we're being energized by the Holy Spirit, when we know the will of God. There is a joy, there's a completeness, there's a satisfaction. There is something within us that really knows that we are secure in Jesus Christ. We're confident in him. There's joy that we have from him. And then here, listen to this, giving thanks to the Father. And so as we pray and people are praying for us, we will always give thanks to the Father. Now, what do we give thanks for? Notice this, who has qualified us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. He has qualified you. Isn't that amazing? You really don't qualify yourself. You don't make yourself qualified by your works and your good deeds and those things that you try to do to please him. Actually, because you are in the will of God, walking in the will of God, it is the Father who qualifies you. He's the one who gives you that quality, that value before him. He's already given you that. We just recognize it and realize it when we're walking in the light. Now notice, as we share in the inheritance of the saints in the light. I like the very next verse. It says, "He has delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins." Boy, you put all that together. What a blessed experience it is, because God qualifies us. We have an inheritance with the saints in the light instead of darkness, because we have been transformed from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear Son. Before we're saved, we walk in darkness. We do not know at what we stumble. But because of redemption, because of restoration, because of forgiveness of sins through the blood of Jesus Christ, we now can be qualified to be a part of the inheritance of all the saints, of all glory in the light. Oh, what a difference. Man, my friend, that's what you and I want. That's where we need to be. And that's what we should pray for others. God help us as we pray this for others even today. God bless.